Ms. Ritu Beri, congratulations for your latest Khadi collection, which you have just launched at Khadi India's center at Connaught Place, Delhi. And it's very symbolic also because today it's Handloom Day. And before we discuss Handloom Day in general, kindly, you know, tell us about your latest collection. What are the key highlights?
I'm a big fan of Khadi as a fabric since the day I started my fashion career 25 years ago. So for me, khadi is really a national fabric. It's a very versatile fabric. It's like they were saying today, it's an air-conditioned fabric because for our country, it really works very well. And all the designs are very modern. You can do very modern, you can do traditional. So it's really, there are many possibilities. And I personally think that as Indians and as proud Indians, we must support our national fabric and we must all wear khadi at some point or the other. So I'm a big promoter for the young and the old and the every generation. I think there's always something for everybody.
Was it nostalgic as well? Because earlier you were mentioning your first collection, which was sold out, was also of khadi.
Well, I really like the fabric and I started off like that, and people would not believe that it's khadi. Even today when I did the collection, a lot of people touched it and said, is it really khadi?
Mm-hmm.
Khadi is a beautiful fabric and very zero carbon and very easy to wear. And I think everyone should try it out.
Today is India Handloom Day. What is your message, you know, to all people who are interested in handloom?
I think we must all support, like khadi is a hand-spun, hand-woven fabric. I think we must support our tradition, we must support our culture. We are very proud of our Indian heritage, and it should be, I'm very happy for today.
Joining today at the launch is Miss Meenakshi. How did you find the collection?
Really beautiful, striking, and what is most important is that people talk about a common man's usage of khadi. Nobody is stopping a common man from wearing khadi. In fact, it was the common man who has been promoting and wearing khadi all this time, but nobody really bothered. The patronage has to come from the well-heeled and the moneyed class, and that is only possible when the rich and people with money power start wearing khadi and start promoting khadi, because patronage always comes not
right.
from the people who can afford. And to make it trendy, to make it fashionable, to make it a fabric which always talks about nationalism, which is talking about sustainable development.
Right.
Khadi,
because
is
when
the best
when you
example.
Endorse khadi, you endorse sustainable fashion.
Absolutely.
As well.
Absolutely. You're endorsing zero footprint of carbon, and zero carbon. That means zero impact on the environment. And zero carbon, which is great, because we all talk about sustainable development, but if a fabric is going to utilize 53 liters of water for making only 1 meter, that is not sustainable. So now with usage of khadi, it's using about 3 liters per meter, which is most sustainable fabric in the world.
Right.
And breathable fabric. A fabric which gives a lot of employment to many people, because from hand spun to hand woven, and everything which is highly skilled is really important. So this was the fabric which gave us the freedom movement, and I feel from freedom of India to the freedom of Republic.
Right.
And the fabric of Republic is what khadi should be.
Before we sign off, what is your message, you know, to young people who should really endorse, you know, khadi?
I feel the sentiment and the emotion which should generate the purchase of khadi is that every cloth you pick up, you are giving employment and you are sending food to some poor, impoverished household. That should be the motivation, that India can't be the golden bird that we all want it to be until and unless everybody manages to get the food and is sustainable.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.